want to go right ahead and bring out our first guest. We're talking about Science Week in the Buffalo Public Schools, and as the biomedical field is expanding, we're seeing emerging job opportunities right here in Buffalo. Now, to prepare students for this evolving job field, Buffalo Public Schools have started their first ever Science Week. And we're joined right now by Mayor Byron Brown to tell us a little bit more about what's happening in and out of the classrooms this week. Welcome back to the couch this morning.
Good to be with both of you.
Well, thank you for coming on this very busy morning. I know you always have a lot to do, but before we start getting into everything, why don't you give us a background of Buffalo Science Week?
So Buffalo Science Week was the brainchild of SUNY trustee Eunice Lewin, who looked at the fact that science is really, jobs are growing in Buffalo, Niagara. They're growing around the country, growing internationally, and a tremendous opportunity for young people to be prepared for the jobs of the future. Also, science learning and science education really helps young people to learn and do well in school. So the thought was, do a whole week to expose young people in the Buffalo Public Schools to science, to expose them to the STEM fields, science, technology, engineering, mathematics, which are exploding with jobs and opportunities, and it's been going fantastic.
What are some of the activities that students have been participating in? We know today is the official Nano Day in the city of Buffalo, right?
Yep, today is the official Nano Day. Nanotechnology, again, is another field that is exploding, another field with more and more jobs that are being created. Nano is huge in Albany. There is a SUNY Nano Center in Albany, literally has pumped millions and millions of dollars into that economy. Some of the things that students will do, they'll see hands-on and interactive displays. There will be speakers. There will be young people who are in college, who are working on their graduate degrees, their PhDs, that are talking about their science learning. And, you know, young people that young students in school can relate to in terms of why they should study science, why they should go into science, all with the goal of getting more young people to graduate from high school, go on to college, graduate from college, and energize the economy of Buffalo, Niagara.
And that leads us right into talking about Say Yes to Education. You just got back from a trip to LA where you were promoting our Say Yes to Education program here in Buffalo, right?
Yeah, I did. It was an exciting opportunity to talk about how Say Yes is helping young people get into college, how it's providing scholarships to all the young people who graduate from a Buffalo public or charter school. And it's also providing them with the supports they need to be able to graduate from high school so that they can get into college. Right now, there are over 1,000 Say Yes scholars who are in college in just the second year of the program. And already we have seen high school graduation rates rise in the Buffalo public schools and more young people from the Buffalo public schools going on to college, so very exciting.
All right, well, you know, you're always so busy. We talked about two things that you're working on right now. That means we have to look towards the future, and you always have something planned. So what can we expect to see in the next couple months?
Well, in the next couple of months, one of the big things I'm working on is the city budget. And our goal is to continue to hold the line on property taxes. During my time as mayor, we've cut the tax rate by 15% residentially, 28% commercially. We're trying to hold the line on taxes again. We're trying not to reassess people's properties. So Buffalo remains an affordable place to live, work, and visit. We want to try to attract more businesses and more residents to the city of Buffalo.
And there's always a lot to look forward to coming up with this summer as well. That's your busy season. You also have a reading program that kicks off soon.
We have a great summer reading program for young people. Last year, there were over 1,500 young people that participated in the Mayor's Summer Reading Program. We're getting ready to kick off the program today, so thank you very much for that. And it's expanded, so it's from it's for children from K all the way to the 12th grade. Reading is so important for young people being able to do well in school, and we really try to encourage young people to read over the summer.
Well, you'll have to make sure you talk to the local office. Or Lisa Scott, who's sitting in our Tim Hortons green room, who's going to be talking about her book. Maybe it could be one of the books that a lot of children read.
I saw her book. It looks fantastic. I think the kids would love it.
Excellent.
That sounds great. Happy Science Week. Thanks again for stopping on the couch. What was your favorite scientific field to study in school?
You know, when I was a kid, I remember in the fifth grade building this robot that actually moved. It was such an exciting experience for me. And one of the things that really got me excited about school, got me excited about learning, and even though I didn't go into a scientific profession, just doing that robot, learning about science, really kept me excited about school.
Well, political science is a form of science,
yes,
too, right?
Right.
All right, thank you so much, Buffalo Mayor Byron Brown, for joining us on the couch this morning. We appreciate your time, as always.
My pleasure to be with you.
All right.